morning, chairpersons, and very good morning to all of you. Today I'm going to present a case of a chemical burn in an infant. We know that ocular injuries are true ocular emergencies. Chemical injuries are true ocular emergencies which require early diagnosis and intensive management. It can result in extensive damage to the ocular surface as well to the eye, so it can lead to extensive visual loss and even loss of eye. But the chemical injuries in pediatric age group pose a greater challenge because of difficulty in early diagnosis and difficulty in the management in pediatric age group. The most common injury reported in pediatric patients are lime burn due to bursting of edible tuna packets, which is very common we see in children, the lime burn and followed by toilet cleaner according to another study. Here I am to present a chemical injury by trichloroacetic acid in a children which has not been reported previously. I searched the literature, I did not find any single case which has been reported for TCA injury in an infant. This is the first case which I am reporting. The other lime burn injuries have been reported, but there is no TCA burn injury reported in an infant. So I am presenting a case. History is like that. A 10-month-old child was taken for ocular examination for complaints of watering and redness in the left eye. So a local anesthetic drop was instilled in the lower fornix for examination of this child. But on instilling this local anesthetic drop, what it was found that there was a whiteness in the cornea in the lower half as soon as the drop was instilled in the eye, the local anesthetic drop. So whole cornea in the lower half became white. So immediately it was washed with copious amount of normal saline, and then the patient was referred to me. So when I examined, I found that the superficial corneal burn was there in this area, involving the lower half of the cornea, encroaching almost up to the pupillary border, along with the conjunctiva was also involved in the adjoining area, and the fluorescein staining was positive in this lower half of the cornea and the conjunctiva. So there was a burn on instilling the local anesthetic drop. So when we graded, it was a grade 3 burn, our Duwa's classification, and it carries a good prognosis. So child was treated immediately with the conservative line of treatment. So we gave fluoromethanol 0.1% eye drop 2 hourly, initially for 1 week, then it was gradually tapered. We gave tobramycin eye drop 4 times and a lubricating drops 0.5% in daytime and 1% at the night application. So child was continued on this line of management, and we followed the child, and what we found that it gradually healed on day one. The first picture is day one. This was at the time of presentation. Then on day four, the defect gradually healed in 7 days. In 14 days, there was only small defect left. And in 3 weeks time, it completely healed because it was a superficial burn, and we could manage it very nicely. Immediately, patient was referred, and we treated conservatively. Child improved also. So when we tried to find out what was the cause of this chemical burn when instilling local anesthetic, it was found that this vial of lidocaine 4% was not containing lidocaine. It was containing a TCA 30%. That is the problem which was there. This vial was not labeled properly. This was a vial, the contents were replaced by some staff, and it was lying there in the staff, and asked to put the local drop, it was a TCA which was not labeled properly. It was a multispecialty hospital. So TCA is commonly used by the dermatologist and by the ENT people for cauterization. So in a multispecialty setting, you will find these vials are there which may be replaced by some other contents. So one should see whether what it contains, whether it is the same chemical, it is containing something else. So when I searched the literature, I found there are very few cases of adults reported of TCA burn. That too when the facial peeling was done by dermatologist on the face by TCA, so it seeped into the patient's eye. So these are two or three reports which I could find in literature reported by in dermatology journal. This occurred when TCA peeling was done for the facial rejuvenation. But there is no any other case report of TCA injury occurring in an infant by the accidental burn which has occurred. So we know the injury. These injuries required immediate evaluation and intensive management for the proper healing of the vial. And the message which I want to give here is that the content of vial should never be replaced by another chemical. And if it is replaced, it should be labeled properly. And secondly, we should always check before instilling into the eye. Otherwise, it can lead to such kind of accidental burns. Thank you so much.
A very nice presentation, Dr. Gupta. What I would like to ask is, do you think is there any kind of medical legal in this, because this is something iatrogenic where it's been put by the hospital staff.
By the staff.
So did you take any kind of...
No, it was not in my hospital. Actually, it was referred to me.
It was referred to
me, but immediately it was referred to me. So I managed it, could manage it properly. But there's a lesson which I learned that we should never replace, and replace should be properly labeled in a bold letters.
So did you check that TCA bottle? Does it have that typical acidic plunging
Yeah,
smell?
It was there. So I think
this is a very important point that before instilling anything, we need to see the smell also.
Smell also,
something which is very, very dangerous. Again, all the examinations, did you do it under general anesthesia? Like
yes, first were under general anesthesia, then I was to follow the patient under local sedation only. And it healed. That was which I was worried when the child was brought to me, a 9-month, 10-month-old child with such a burn. It was a weak acid, 30%, so it healed immediately.
another question what I would like to ask you is, does it cause any deeper penetration, TCA? Could you find
any? No, it's a superficial burn. It coagulates the protein, doesn't print it deeper. That's why it healed fast in 2 to 3 weeks' time, and we could manage the child very well. Otherwise, on the day one, the picture was very bad. That what will happen, because child are very uncooperative for examination, for putting drops. So we had to put a patch and open it every 2 hourly.
Excellent.
Thank you so much. Thank you.